cause and effect. I seen the world, bro, I've been to Tibet. All of the bags that this kid finna get. You out here doing the same shit again and again. I'm surprised we ain't sick of you yet. Ooh. Yeah, I sip the bourbon, bitch, I put the work in. Look, I've been a factor. Pull my car, your arm, get a fracture. You ain't real, but you been an actor. I know the soil like I'm in a tractor, like John Deere.
How you doing, guys? I'm 905, and welcome back to another Let's Play. Today, Armored Warfare. And I haven't played World of Templates since the update 3.9 dropped, and all the recent videos you might see on my channel has been from the update 3.8. And I'm also really short of time at the moment to play or to record anything. A lot of things going on in my life right now, so... now I have a free morning. And I wanted to check out the Armored Warfare finally. So this is it. This is not the first impressions video. I already did a couple of battles. So I can tell you a few things about it. Like, for example, when you just start your account, you are given 3 tanks. You got the M41 Walker Bulldog. Yep, the same one that's in Blitz right now. Looks really cool though. So, and this tank has an 11 shot autoloader that reloads for 30 seconds, and it has like 2 or 3 seconds between each shot. So that's one of the tanks you get. The other one is a PT-76, which I don't really understand. I mean, it looks like RU-251, and it looks that it's fast with a shitty gun, but actually it's not fast, and the gun is shitty, and it has no armor whatsoever. So I didn't like that tank. I think it's complete shit. Maybe if you upgraded it, but well, let's see, maybe one day. And this is my current favorite tank, the Type 62. And I actually gathered enough XP to open the tier 2 tank, and tier 2 tank is Type 69. So, I don't know. Yeah, let's do a couple battles in the Type 69. What can I upgrade it? I can put a new engine in it. What is this? Insufficient XP to unlock. Okay, it's fine. Yeah, let's play type 69. And today we're gonna be looking at the PvE missions. First, when you start the game, there's no PvP available. You just have to start with PvE missions. And PvE missions are basically what it is there's a matchmaker that finds you and a couple other guys, and you get put in one team, and you basically have to go and kill bots, and you can earn credits for that, and you can earn XP for that. Basically, it's like a capture the base type thing. You go somewhere, capture the base, then defend the base, and there's quite a few modes. So let's go check out the PvE missions today. Right now, there's only easy contracts available. I guess if you advanced further, there's a medium and hard one as well. But for me, for now, it's only easy contract available. So this is the matchmaker, the mission queue, how many players are in the queue, how many players are looking for easy missions, the ones that I'm looking for now, how many for the medium, and so forth. Oh, and we already got a mission. So we're joining some guys, and we'll get to be in the first mission in a moment. Operation Snakebite. PLM forces are invading neighborhood town while they are engaged. Move in and take over the supply depot. Okay. So move in and take over the supply depot means just go there and cap the base. You see primary objectives, take over the depot, and secondary. And the other primary is defend the depot. And there's a secondary objective as well, recover convoys. I don't know that. So I played this one before. So you see on the bottom right corner there's a mini map, and the yellow triangle, that's me. The blue ones are my allies. And when the enemy is going to be spotted, they will be marked as reds. And if you see the bottom right corner there on the map, there's like this red circle. And that's basically... Oh my god, this tank doesn't turn at all. Put a shot into the T-54. So far I have nothing good to say about this thing. The tier 1 type, the 51, no, the 62, it was really cool. It was fast with a decent gun. This one probably just has better armor, but it also looks a lot slower than that one. Maybe I need to upgrade it. Gun depression. Oh, didn't pen the pattern. So all the enemies in this PvE mode are bots, which you can see by how the way they drive. And also, there's a couple types of bots. There's like a fragile tanks that only have like 400 HPs that you can basically take off with one shot if you're lucky. And then there's how like a regular tanks that has like about 2k HPs. And then there's like lieutenants, like a mini raid bosses with like 3k. Okay, he's done. Oh shit. Didn't notice that one. So let's slowly move towards the cap circle. And take these two tanks out. Can I, no. Can't see. Yeah, put a shot into him. Gonna finish him off here. Yep, that's mine. So there's another one there. I'm just gonna move up there to the cap circle, try to cap the base and shoot from the vantage point up there. Oh, can I get a cheeky shot in here? Yep, that went into the pattern. You see, that's a fragile one there. He only has 400 HPs. Yeah, one shot. Oh shit, and that's a lieutenant, see? 3.2. Oh, shit. Try to side scrape. Put a shot into him. Another one into the lieutenant. Hit the angled tank. There's one attacking from there. And I'm not really sure, but it looks like that's the gunner that has been killed. Yeah, it looks like a gunner, because the gun doesn't aim at all. So we almost kept the base. There's still 8-7 seconds to go. 2-1. So we kept the base. And there, now on the top right corner, there's a countdown, and we have to defend it now. After the timer runs out, we won the battle. Wow. Put a shot into that one, even though my gunner is shit. Yeah, kill shot on that. The fragile one. Come on. Nope. Kill that one. That one's dead as well. One from down there, he's dead. I think I'll just keep an eye on this, top location right here, and I already get my gun aimed. So when they appear, I can already shoot them. He's down there, and that's a fragile one. Yeah, there's no point for me to move there. By the time I'm gonna get my gun aimed there, he'll be dead. Maybe I can get a shot into that one. Auto aim. No gun depression. Snapshot. Snapshot didn't pen. Shit. Okay. Driving backwards. I guess for the next mission I'll take the Type 62, it's a lot faster and better at relocating. Finishing that one off. There's another pattern. He's dead. Can I finish him off? Low roll. 20 HP is left. Let's try to put a shot in this fragile T-54. And he disappeared. Oh, there's one. It's only there. Nope, no pen. Try to aim for the lower plate, but still, no. Didn't go in. Got that one. So there's 30 seconds left. Let's try to get some more damage in. Kill that one as well. Reloading. Can I get a shot into? Oh, no, they managed to reload in time. I think this is it. There's 10 more seconds left, and I doubt that I will get another shot into somewhere. Maybe if I'm really lucky. Nope. So that's the first PvE mission. You go cap a base and try to defend it. And it's really cool to do that, to farm some credits and some XP so you can unlock the modules and farm a little bit of cash. Great job, you have been awarded 200,000. Use this to purchase retrofits. Flag consumables. Okay. So this is the battle results. You can see I get 17,000 credits for it, 1.2k exp, and if I would get a premium account, I would get a bit more than that. Teams, you can see how much damage you've done, how many you've killed, how much XP you got for that. So this was pretty competitive team. Everybody did about 6k damage, except for these two. But so let's try to. Okay. Let's see if I can upgrade it. Maybe give it a better engine, or I think that's it. There's only two of them. Anyway, so let's take a Type 62 for the next battle. It's a bit faster. Can I upgrade this one? Reduce aim time. Okay. Can I lock that? Okay. So I'm guessing, so that's a regular IP, 306 to 374 280 pen 230. Yeah, so heat penetrates more, and that's high explosive. Okay, confirm. I have no idea about these ones. I'll explore them later, all the consumables. Let's just go and have some more fun in a PvE. So where was he? The player queue, difficulties, tiers, how many players per tier. And you can also see what kind of classes are playing at the moment. The light tanks, 8 of them. SPGs, I think that's artillery. Tank destroyers, main battle tanks, and AFV, I'm not sure, but I think that's those tanks that that drive on wheels instead of the tracks, and they use machine guns, like they're fast to relocate, but like basically like the scout tanks, but don't quote me on that one. What else can I show you? The crew. See, my commander has gotten one extra level. It's tier 2 now. So, Operation Spearhead. Take over the refinery and don't let them get their hands on any more fuel. So, I guess it's another type of capture the base system here. Just go there, cap the base and defend them. Capture, destroy generators. Destroy generators, that's 3 of them. That's probably those 3 dots. The first one is right there in E3, E2. So let's go to E2, try to destroy the generator first. And then move towards the cap circle there. This is much faster than the second tier tank. Oh, first one down. So, which is the, oh, this one. Okay, that's destroyed. Another one down. Oh, okay. That's just too easy. Let's f- Fuck it, let's destroy the generator first and then deal with enemy tanks. Oh, he's done. Fuck, I'm in the middle of everybody now. One into the pattern. Shit. So I've been tracked in the bottom left corner. You can see the timer sticking away until the track is repaired. If I've gotten consumables, I probably could repair it straight away, but I don't. Shit. Come on. Yeah, kill that one. I wanna go and find that final generator and then take care of the base. Where is it? Oh, that's it. That's the generator. Finish off this one. Try to side scrape here. To the sides and move into the cap circle. Finish this one off and start capping the base. Shit. Okay. So there's pattern. I'm hiding behind this dead tank here. One into the lower plate. Shit. There's one from there as well. Hopefully that PT-76 finishes him off. No, I have to do everything my fucking self. Shit. Okay. I wish I've got some fucking help in this battle. Oh, went into the turret. Okay. There, but I don't think I see them. I just kept the base while the rest of my team is fucking around there. Well, at least they're having fun. Seconds to go. So F7 is help. F6 is negative, so F5 is affirmative. What else? Oh, okay. F3. F4, defend the base. And F1, you can see what each button does. So we completed this mission, got some more credits, some more XP. So I'll think, let's do another one. The final one, how about the PvE system, and then I'll probably do a next video on the PvP system. So what did I get? 400 XP, 11,000 credits, did the most damage. Okay. Actually, you know what? Garage. I'll show you the Walker Bulldog for the last one. Can I maybe upgrade it? The better engine inside it. No? I guess I don't have the XP to do that. Anyway, well, let's drive stock. Let's drive stock tank. So in dealers you can buy the three tanks. There's three factions. One is, I guess, is Americans, where you start off with the Bulldog and you move down. Legendary M60 there. M1 Abrams, M1 A1 Abrams. You get the point, like American type tanks. Then these ones, I guess, are like Russians. T-55, T-62. T-90, T-14 Armata, and like a Chinese tanks, Type 62, Type 69, Type 79, 80, all the way up to, well, these are PvE only tanks. These are, I think, are the artillery that you can use only in a PvE, and those are the premium tanks that you can buy for real credits, I mean for the gold. For the real money, I meant to say. And so what's here? With the Russians, they have... Oh, that's light tanks. Okay, we join in a mission. There's only three premium tanks you can buy from the Russian tank tree. And quite a few Americans, if you're into that kind of thing. I'm not buying any premium tanks at the moment because I don't, I'm not sure if I'm gonna stay in this game at all, but so far it's really cool. I really want to check out the PvP system as well, but I don't have any decent tier tanks, and when I tried to join the PvP system with my tier 1 tank, I couldn't find any players. So capture the port. Let's go capture the port. So that's my Walker Bulldog. So those three blue circles are where you have to go and download the intel from. So let's try to do that. Let's go to that D6 up there. So you see in the middle of the screen there's 20 seconds, 19 seconds. That's my autoloader reloading. And just left of that is how many shells I have. So far it's 0 out of 11 because I'm reloading. And I think the 4 seconds is between the shots I'm reloading. One into that one. Oh, didn't pen. Finished him off. Did we get the intel? I don't know. Did I have to stay there or was it already? Well, I tried. So. Okay. One into the Walker. Try to finish him off here. Okay. How many shells I have left? 5. There's one. No, where are you? No, went low. So I have 4 shells left. Should be enough to take out that FT-76. One into him and finish him off. Okay. Can I reload? Yeah, I'm reloading. 24 seconds left. The reload is the same as on World of Tanks Blitz. You push the C button. Oh, fucking, I'm reloading. There's a. Oh, great teamwork. Shit, there's another one. Okay, So let's go and cap the base. This team looks pretty decent. They all know what they're doing. He's dead. As you can see with the bots, you can play pretty careless and drive out with your sides open. On PvP, I probably wouldn't recommend that, and would recommend to do all the, you know, the usual stuff, side scrape and hull downs and stuff like that. But yeah, for the PvE, if you just want to farm some credits and just have some fun without too much tension, that I would definitely recommend you check out the PvE mode. So I think this is it, and this will conclude my PvE session and my first Let's Play about Armored Warfare. Hope you enjoyed it, and if you want to see more episodes, don't forget to like and leave a comment as well. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one.